First, let's first begin with tafsir of Ibn Kathir. On the verse, Ibn Kathir explains, but you cannot make here those who are in graves means, just as the dead cannot benefit from guidance and the call to truth after they have died as disbelievers and ended up in the graves, so too you cannot help these idolaters who are decreed to be doomed, and you cannot guide them. Now clearly from the explanation of the tafsir, the verse isn't saying that the dead cannot hear, but rather they cannot receive guidance. And if they died as kafir, they will be judged as such, and no one, not even the Prophet ﷺ, can provide guidance for them, for their time has expired, it's ended. Let's have a look at Jalalain, Tafsir al-Jalalain. Tafsir al-Jalalain states, nor are the living equal to the dead, the believers and the disbelievers, respectively. The addition of the particle la, nor, in all three instances, is for emphasis. Indeed, God makes to hear whomever he wishes to be guided, so that such a person then responds to him by embracing faith. But you cannot make those who are in the graves to hear, namely the disbelievers, whom he has likened to the dead, to hear and so respond. So again, this tafsir also shows that the verse is actually speaking about hearing, listening and receiving guidance in regards to the dead, and furthermore the verse is actually speaking of the dead disbelievers, and that the disbelievers are likened to the dead, that they can't hear, namely guidance. Imam As-Suyuti in Al-Hawi Lil-Fatawa explains that it is an allegorical statement. The verse is an allegorical statement. النفي جاء على معنى المجاز. The real meaning of this is that they cannot listen to guidance. معناها سمع هدى. They can't listen to هدى, guidance. I.e. they are dead and cannot be guided anymore. Now let's have a look at one last tafsir before we continue on with the proof text for our position. Let's have a look at the tafsir of Mufti Shafi' Uthmani, the father of Mufti Taqi Uthmani in Ma'rif al-Qur'an. And the tafsir says, at the beginning of the verse, وَمَا أَنْتَ بِمُسْمِعٍ مَّنْ فِي الْقُبُورِ, and you cannot make hear those who are in the graves. Verse 22, disbelievers have been likened to the dead and believers to the living. In congruence to this, the expression مَنْ فِي الْقُبُرِ, those in the graves, here means the disbelievers. The disbelievers, man fil qubur, here means the disbelievers. The sense is that the way you cannot make the dead hear you, you can also not make these living disbelievers hear you. This verse has itself clarified it that at this place, making someone hear means the kind of listening that is going to be useful, effective, and beneficial. Otherwise, the effort of making disbelievers listen, in the absolute sense, has remained an exercise in futility since ever. It has even been a matter of common observation that a call was beamed at them, and they did listen to it. Therefore, the verse means that the way you cannot bring the dead to the right path by making them hear the divine word, because they have shifted from the avenue of deeds in the world to the arena of recompense in the hereafter, where even if they confess to their faith, it will not be deemed as trustworthy, similar to that is the condition of the disbelievers. This proves that the negation of making the dead hear referred to in this verse means a particular listening that is beneficial, something because of which the listener forsakes the false and takes to the true. From this presentation, it becomes clear that the present verse has nothing to do with the issue of the ability of the dead to hear. Whether or not the dead hear the living is a different issue in its own place. Ma'rif al-Qur'an, volume number 7, page number 335 and 336. So alhamdulillah, this verse, which is used by those who object to the idea of the dead being able to hear, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as well, is no proof text for them at all.